This is why the United States and the world needs to pay attention to Taiwan. Hey everyone, so recently I've been feeling a bit tired and down, especially after every day hearing so much negative news about people getting sick. And with all of this fear and negativity, I think a lot of people feel the same way. And really, it's no wonder that everyone feels so worried. But this week, I want to try and do something a little different and take all of this bad news and turn it into something a bit more constructive. Because I think a lot of the world can learn a few things from the way that Taiwan has been handling this public health crisis. While the rest of the world seems to be confused and panicked, people in Taiwan have remained relatively calm, rational, and informed. This, along with the fast and aggressive response by the Taiwanese government and healthcare system, has led Taiwan to be one of the best prepared countries affected so far. And I really think the United States and the rest of the world should pay attention to Taiwan, especially to the things that they've done right so far. The best evidence of this is by looking at Taiwan's situation today, especially when compared to other countries in the region. Taiwan is a country less than 200 kilometers away from mainland China. Not to mention the two have very close economic and travel links. Yet compared to similar East Asian countries, Taiwan has managed to contain the outbreak on an unprecedented level. Whereas places like mainland China have seen over 80,000 cases, and other countries like Japan reporting over 1,000, and in South Korea the number is quickly increasing and approaching 8,000 total cases. This all the while, Taiwan has seen less than 50 total cases and only one reported death. Yet despite all of this, Taiwan's response has been overlooked by other countries, and what's more, is still not included in the WHO, despite having one of the best healthcare responses of any country in the region. Meanwhile, countries thousands of miles away in Europe, the Middle East, and for me, closer to home in North America, are seeing the virus spread rapidly, and this is causing people to panic. This is especially worrying to me because my family is all still living in the United States, where things are getting worse every day. And of course, I worry about their health and well-being more than anything else. That's why I really hope people pay attention to this video and learn from what Taiwan has done so well in order to stay safe and healthy. So what exactly is Taiwan doing right? And what can other countries like the United States learn from Taiwan? Well, let's first look at what steps Taiwan took early on in the outbreak. During the early stages, Taiwan cut off all direct flights from affected regions like China and has issued a mandatory 14-day quarantine for all people returning from affected countries. More importantly, people who break this quarantine are fined upwards of $30,000. This not only limits the inflow of people from affected countries, but also isolates people at risk, and more importantly, penalizes people who do not comply. Meanwhile, the United States has also implemented a quarantine, but people there continue to attend public events and ignore the advice of public health officials. This is what's helping the virus spread faster day by day. Aside from this, Taiwan was also quick to act by closing all public schools and universities early on, as well as canceling major public events. It's actions like these that led to Taiwan's success so far. The next thing that Taiwan has done extremely well is its implementation of rigorous public health screenings. This means temperature checks before entering places like hospitals, government buildings, tourist landmarks, schools, and universities. Many people in the US and other countries might see this as a violation of personal freedom, but I can attest to the importance of measures like these. People like myself and every other person in Taiwan has had to go through temperature checks almost daily while traveling outside. But these few extra minutes or even seconds each day have seemed to work. This, accompanied by mandatory hand sanitation in these public places, has also helped to catch early cases as well as improve public sanitation. A big problem in other countries like the US is the prevalence of panic buying for things like face masks and hand sanitizer. Recently, while on the phone with my mom, she told me that all supermarkets and pharmacies are sold out, and people have begun to panic buy everything in the store. This is also an area in which Taiwan has intervened by putting daily buying limits on sanitation products and has even implemented a rationing system based on your national ID number to ensure that all people have equal access and a fair chance to buy the things that they need. Taiwan has also put in steep fines on reselling and price gouging, another big problem in the US right now. Taiwan is an example of how responsible policies and actions by the government can prevent panic, increase fairness, and improve public health. The final thing that Taiwan has done remarkably well is the free flow of information and transparency between the government, news agencies, and health services. This is in contrast to countries like China and Thailand, where misinformation, censorship, and delayed reportings have made things even worse. Even in places like the United States, mistrust in the government or in local media institutions is making the problem more difficult to control. Taiwan, on the other hand, has been extremely proactive in communicating up-to-date information and aggressively pushing public health education. This includes health and safety announcements on public transit, TV, radio, and in public areas. This includes important sanitation information like proper hand washing, appropriate mask usage, and even a special public health hotline. All in all, these steps have been effective. Again, just look at these numbers. Considering its situation and location, Taiwan has been able to handle the virus like no other country in the world. It's an example of how the open flow of information, effective quarantine procedures, broad screenings in public places, and public sanitation education can help to contain the virus. This is all while allowing people to continue their everyday lives with minimal impact. As someone who is living here and experiencing life day to day, I can only applaud Taiwan in the responsible and organized way that it's handled things this far. For all the governments and nations affected by the virus, I urge you to take a close look at Taiwan and use Taiwan as an example. And remember that Taiwan can help. As for myself, I feel extremely grateful to be living in Taiwan. There's really no other place in the world I'd rather be at a time like this. Like everyone, I hope that this issue was resolved as soon as possible and that we can all stay safe and healthy over the following weeks and months. For everyone watching, take care, stay safe, and be healthy.